Hello, Daniel.
Hello, Jesus. How's it going?
I don't understand.
How are you doing?
Well, thanks. And you?
Good, good. Did you have a good weekend?
Yes, very well. And
Excellent.
you?
Yeah, it was good. I've moved into a new house.
Ah, yes. You
De
have a
nuevo.
new house.
Nuevo departamento, sí.
Ah, okay. Congratulations.
Thank you, thank you.
Hi.
Hello, Pedro.
Hello, Jesús.
Hi, Pedro.
Hi, Daniel.
Wow, I have both of you in the same class. Tengo los dos en la misma clase.
Ah, por fin. Sí.
Bueno. Today we are going to do review. Okay? Review. So we need to talk about nine units. Tenemos que hablar de nuevas clases. Okay? Pero esta clase es más o menos pruebas de cada tema para practicar lo que ya entendemos. ¿Okay? Y entiendo que cada uno ha faltado una clase, ¿no?
No,
Pero
yo falté dos.
dos, ah, bueno, está bien, ok. Pero ¿han visto las últimas clases que han perdido? No, no, ok, está
No,
bien.
yo no la puedo ver, lo siento.
Bueno. Está bien,
No.
porque pueden aprender mientras la otra está practicando. ¿Okay?
Okay.
Okay. Pero vamos a empezar de las primeras clases. ¿Okay? Entonces, pruebas. Okay. Para empezar, vamos a hablar de los verbos to be or to have. ¿Okay? En estos ejemplos, necesiten decidir si vamos a usar el verbo to have o el verbo to be. ¿Okay? Entonces, Jesús, ¿puedes leer número uno?
Yes. Good question.
Bueno, okay, aquí es el sentimiento. ¿Okay? Es como
Sentimiento.
me siento frío. ¿Okay? Como decir,
Okay.
tengo frío, tengo frío. ¿Okay?
Then I have call.
Bueno, Pedro, ¿qué piensas? Ah, tienes un resfriado.
Sí.
Bueno, yo también un poco. Yo también.
Yo creo haberlo leído y creo que sí dice I am cold, pero no estoy
Bueno.
seguro.
Es así, ¿okay? Jesús, cuando decimos I have a cold, es como decir tengo un resfriado.
Como Pedro.
Como Pedro, sí. Sí. Entonces, pero cuando queremos decir tengo frío, queremos, como el sentimiento, decimos I am. Cold.
Okay.
Okay. Bueno, y número dos, Pedro.
Dos.
Sí.
I have a cold.
I have a cold. Good. Okay, bueno, y tienen que ver la diferencia aquí, ¿okay? A cold
A
es
cold.
una
I am
cosa,
sick.
es un
Okay.
sustantivo, a cold,
A
¿okay?
cold.
Pero el sentimiento, no tenemos una preposición enfrente, o un artículo enfrente, ¿okay? Solamente I am. Ok, Jesús, número 3.
This. I think is I'm a little hungry.
Good. I'm a little hungry. Bueno, ¿entiendes que en español usamos el verbo tener? Pero en inglés, cuando estamos hablando de hambre, decimos yo estoy. I am hungry. Good. Very good. Pedro, number four.
He has a lot of money.
Good, good. Él tiene mucho dinero.
Sí.
Jesús, can you read number five?
Yes. These students are very smart.
Very good, very good. These students are very smart. Perfect. Number six, Pedro.
Thomas has two children.
Perfect. Jesus, number seven.
I am sleepy.
Otra vez.
I am sleepy.
Good. I am sleepy. Perfect. Pedro, number eight.
Mary is 24 years old.
Perfect. Number nine, Jesus.
The athletes are not tired.
Good, okay, bueno, otra vez es un sentimiento, ¿no? Entonces usamos el verbo to be. Okay, it's a feeling. It's a feeling. So we use the verb to be. Okay. Jesús, esta palabra,
yes.
Los atléticos,
sí.
Se dice athletes.
Athletes.
Yeah, good.
Athletes.
Okay. Así. Athletes.
Athletes.
Good. Athletes.
Athletes. Athletes.
Athletes. Good.
Athletes.
You got it. You got it. Very good. Okay. And the last one, number 10, Pedro.
He has your purse.
Yeah, he has your purse. ¿Qué significa purse?
Bolso o algo así.
Sí, bolsa por las chicas, por las mujeres.
Ah, cartera. Ah, ya. Yeah. Ya, yeah, la cartera de las mujeres, ya. Yeah.
Sí. Bueno, ok. Entonces, ¿entienden cómo usar el verbo to be y el verbo to have? You understand how to use the verb to be and the verb to have. Ok. Bueno. Ah, eso no. Ok. Ahora vamos a hablar de nacionalidades. Ok. Entonces, voy a dar algunas preguntas. Y es una prueba de geografía también un poco. Ok. Pero tienen que acabar las oraciones. Y terminar las oraciones. Entonces, Jesús. Can you read that sentence?
I don't see the screen.
In the chat. Colingo chat.
Okay. Tom is from Berlin. His nationality is Germany.
Okay, bueno. El país se dice... Okay. Pero su nacionalidad es diferente. Alguien de Alemania, somebody from Germany, es
I don't remember.
Okay, no problem. Pedro, do you remember?
Yes, German.
German, yeah. Yes. He, podemos decir, his nationality is
yes.
German, or no.
He's German.
German. He is German.
Wait a moment, please.
Okay. No problem. Okay. Pedro.
Yes.
Una prueba de geografía.
Okay.
A geography test. A geography test. Okay. Quizás es un poco difícil. Can you read that?
Yes. Anne is from Leningrad. Her nationality is Russia.
Okay. The country is Russia. The country is Russia.
Ah, what right. Russian?
Russian, yeah. We say, she is Russian, or her nationality is Russian.
Russian. Russian. Yeah. Okay.
Russian. We say, Russian.
Russian.
Good. Y recuerdes, es como, no es como CH, es más SH. Shh. No ch. Russian.
Russian.
Good. Perfect. Very good. You got it.
Okay.
Okay. Okay. Try this one, Pedro. Try this one.
David is from New York. His nationality is American.
American. Good. American. Perfect. Next.
Sarah is from London. Her nationality is British or maybe English.
Good. Hey, you got both of them. British or English. Cool. Nice one, man. Okay. And this one you can say with an accent if you want. Can you do the name with an accent?
With the accent? With
yeah,
the accent?
For the name.
Nicole.
Yeah, can you finish the sentence?
Okay. Nicole is from Paris. Her nationality is French.
Good, good. So if you do it with the French accent, Nicole.
Nicole.
Nicole. No, I'm kidding. A French accent. French accent.
Ah, okay. French accent.
Good.
I don't care the French accent.
Oh, okay, no problem. No problem. Okay, how about this one?
Carlos is from Madrid. His nationality is Spanish.
Good, you got it. Okay, now we're trying your geography. How about this one?
Oh. Donald is from Geneva. His nationality is Italian?
No.
Or
close.
Greek?
No, close to Italy. North of Italy.
North, tell me. Geneva.
The country.
Grecia.
What?
Ah, no, but Grecia, no?
No. You're close.
España, North Francia, están cerca. Ah, no, difícil.
Okay. Well, how do you say Switzerland in Spanish?
Creo que es Suiza.
Suiza, okay, good.
Sí.
So, somebody from Switzerland.
I don't know.
Okay. You have to remember the cheese. You can remember the cheese, okay? Did you say Swiss?
Swiss.
Okay. So we say, he is Swiss.
He is como, Swiss.
¿Queso suiza se dice?
Sí. Okay.
En inglés se dice Swiss cheese.
Okay.
Swiss cheese.
So
somebody from Switzerland de Suiza is Swiss.
Okay.
All right. How about this one?
Bruce is from Sydney. His nationality is Australian.
Australian. Yeah.
Australian.
Perfect. Okay. This one.
Keiko is from Tokyo. Her nationality is Japanese.
Japanese. Okay. Japanese. And the last one. The last one. Maybe you don't know this one. This is a difficult geography one.
Oh no. Leo is from Jakarta. His nationality. Leo is from Jakarta. His nationality is
Suecia.
Suecia. No tengo idea cómo se dice. No sé nada de Suecia.
No, Sud Asia.
Ah, Sur Asia. Sí, ah, es de Sur Asia. Asia. Ya sé, India.
No, más sur, más sur.
Thailand.
No, más sur.
Más sur.
Es lo mismo en inglés que en español. Indonesia.
Ah.
Se dice Indonesia.
Indonesia.
Indonesia. Okay. Podemos escribirlo lo mismo, pero decimos Indonesia.
Indonesia.
Okay. Okay. Entonces, someone from Indonesia.
He's an Indonesian.
Indonesian. Yeah. Indonesian. So, Dua is Indonesian.
Okay.
Cool. Hey, Pedro, do you have any questions about any countries?
No.
No? You think you know all the nationalities?
No. No.
What about in South America?
Chilean, Argentinian. ¿La nombro?
How many can you tell me? ¿Cuántos puedes decirme?
Ah, ¿el país o la, el gentilicio?
La nacionalidad.
La nacionalidad. Chilean, Argentinian, Peruvian.
Yeah, good.
Brazilian.
Good.
Bolivian. No.
Yeah, you're right.
Bolivian.
Yeah. Bolivian.
Ecuadorian.
Yeah.
Colombian.
Perfect.
Venezuela, no sé. Venezuela.
Yeah. ¿Cómo?
Venezuela. No sé cómo se dice. Venezuelan.
Pues, con un N, al fin. Venezuelan.
Venezuelan.
Yeah.
Falta. Uruguay me falta. ¿Cuál más me falta?
Paraguay and Uruguay.
Claro, Paraguay y Uruguay me faltan. ¿Puede ser Paraguay?
Paraguayan.
Paraguayan.
Yeah.
Paraguayan.
And
Uruguayan.
Uruguayan. Yeah.
Uruguayan.
Cool. Very good. Okay, let's continue. Something else. Okay. Okay, now I want you to tell me jobs. Okay, we're going to talk about jobs. So here we have some pictures. Let's see what you can remember. Okay?
Yeah.
So I want you to tell me a sentence about who they are. So.
Okay, the sentence. So, yeah. She is a letter carrier.
Good. She is a letter carrier, good. And do you remember? Now we say.
Por amam.
Ahora podemos decir letter carrier, pero antes.
Yes, now. Now she is a post woman.
Post woman, yeah. Antes. Dijeron post woman, but now you are right. Letter carrier.
Okay.
Number two.
Number two, he is a dentist.
He is a dentist. Perfect.
Yes.
Number three.
He's a fireman.
He's a fireman or
He's a fireman or
como luchador de fuegos.
No, I don't know.
Firefighter.
Firefighter.
Firefighter. Es por los dos sexos, ¿no? Es la idea nueva de tener una posición por las mujeres y los hombres.
Ah, okay, firefighter.
Firefighter, okay. Como luchador de fuegos.
Okay.
Okay, the next one.
She is a nurse.
She is a nurse. Right?
Yes.
Okay. And next.
And next. He is a doctor or cirujano, no sé cómo se dice.
Yeah, se dice surgeon.
Surgeon.
Yeah, surgeon.
Okay. Surgeon.
Yeah. And the word for cirugía, se dice cirugía.
Sí, cirugía.
Se dice surgery.
Surgery. Okay.
Surgery. La acción. Bueno. Okay, vamos a continuar. Okay. Entonces, Jesús.
Sorry.
No problem. No problem. Jesús, what does he do? What does he do?
He's a banker.
He's a banker. Yeah, you got it. He's a banker. Perfect. Right. Oye, Pedro, no hemos aprendido la próxima. Right? What does he do? ¿Dónde trabaja? Where does he work?
En una bencinera, en una...
Bueno, en inglés se dice gas station.
Gas station.
Estación de gasolina, ¿no? De gas. Sí. Pero decimos gas station attendant.
Ah, okay.
Gas station attendant.
Qué largo.
Okay.
Gas station attendant.
Bueno, y otro trabajo que ya no hemos aprendido. Okay. Jesús.
Yes.
¿Sabes cuál es? What does he do?
The man.
Yeah, the man.
She is a waiter.
Oh no, the man. The man. Here.
The man.
On the
he
left.
He is a cleaner.
Good, he is a cleaner. Pero tenemos una palabra específico cuando es más industrial. Y es esta palabra, janitor. Okay. Normalmente, él es lo que arregla las problemas en un edificio y limpia todo el edificio también. Okay.
Mm.
A janitor.
Conserje.
Sí, sí. And Pedro, the next
sí.
Picture. What does she do?
She's a waiter.
She's a waiter. Okay. Pero waiter es por un hombre.
Mm. I don't know the new word.
Okay, Jesus, you know?
Okay. I think it's waiter, but no, I...
It's okay, it's okay. So did you say waitress? She's a waitress.
Ah, waitress.
Okay. Or, por los dos sexos, se puede decir, she's a server.
Hmm.
She's a server. Okay. Jesus, what does he do?
He's a... Mm. Bus driving.
Okay, close. Bus drive.
Bus driver.
Okay, bus driver. Good. Pedro, do you know the next one? What does he do?
No.
Okay. Jesus, do you know?
Postman.
No, close. I think we would say he's a mover.
He's a mover.
Cosas grandes. Mm. Okay. All right. Jesus. Yes. What does he do?
He's a teacher.
Again, Pedro, what does he do?
Él, I don't know.
Es lo mismo como el otro. Como él.
Ah. He's a mover.
He's a mover. Good.
He's a mover.
Okay. Okay, Jesus, what does he do?
He's a mechanic.
Good. And Pedro, what does she do?
I don't remember it.
Okay. ¿Qué tiene en sus manos?
Trash. Trasher.
Okay.
Is a trasher?
O también se puede decir garbage.
Garbage.
¿Sí? Okay. Entonces, normalmente se dice garbage man, o en este caso...
Garbage man. Garbage woman.
Garbage woman. Good. ¿Sí? Bueno, no sé si la próxima es un profesión. No es un profesión legal. It's not a legal profession. But... ¿Cómo se dice ladrón?
Robbery.
Bueno, la acción es robbery, ¿okay? Pero cuando estamos hablando de la persona, queremos decir, hay dos maneras de decirlo.
¿Stoler?
Ah, no. Cerca. Estás hablando de steal, ¿no?
Sí, Stealer, entonces algo. ¿Stealer?
Sí. Entiendo, pero no es como decimos. Okay.
¿No?
Tenemos que decir, he is a robber, o más común, thief. Así. He is a robber, or he is a thief.
A thief.
Okay. Robber or thief. Un ladrón.
He's a robber. Okay.
Pedro, the next one. What does he do?
He's a doctor.
No.
Está
vendiendo los drogas.
He's a pharmaceutic.
Sí.
¿Sí?
¿Cómo se dice farmacia?
Farmacia.
Sí.
¿Cómo se dice farmacia? I don't know.
Es más o menos lo mismo. Se dice pharmacy, pero es con PH.
Pharmacy.
Y alguien que trabaja en la farmacia se dice pharmacist.
Pharmacist. Okay.
Pharmacist. Okay, Jesus.
Yes.
Can you tell me what do they do?
What picture?
What does she do? What does he do?
She. I don't know. What is she?
Está trabajando con la coche.
Mechanic.
Yes. Woman. Sí, no, se puede decir she's a mechanic.
She's a mechanic.
Okay. And what does he do?
He's a taxi driver.
Good, he's a taxi driver. Perfect. Okay, and Pedro, what does she do?
Yes. He's a police officer.
No, other one. She. What does she do?
Ah, okay. She's a nurse.
No, está en un hotel.
Ah. I don't know.
Jesus, do you remember?
Waiter, no.
No,
I don't.
en español se puede decirlo, pero en inglés tiene otra palabra. She's a maid. She's a maid. Remember? ¿Recuerdan? Okay. Y Pedro, el otro, what does she do? Es una mujer. What does
Ah,
she do?
es una mujer, okay. She's a police officer.
Good. She's a police officer.
Police officer.
Good. Or policewoman, right? Police officer.
Police woman.
Excellent. Okay. Bueno, entienden profesiones, pero hay algunos más. Algunos más. Okay.
Okay.
El primero creo es un cajero. Un cajero. Entonces, Jesús, what does she do?
He's a cashier.
Good. She's a cashier. Excellent.
He's a
Number
woman.
two, Pedro, what does she do? Secretaria.
She's a secretary.
Good. She's a secretary. Perfect. The next one. Jesus, what does he do?
He's a waiter.
He's a waiter, you got it. Okay. Pedro?
He's a policeman
He's a
or police
policeman.
officer.
Good, or
Yes.
police officer, excellent. Jesus, number five, what does he do?
He's a cookie cookman.
Bueno, ¿se puede decir solamente como cocinero? ¿Se puede decir solamente como el verbo? He's a cook. ¿Ya?
Okay.
He's a cook. Se necesita un artículo enfrente para describir un sustantivo. Entonces, he's a cook. O, ¿cómo se dice chef? Sí, es un poco diferente. ¿Recuerdas? Necesitamos decir Sh chef, como SH. Sh
Chef.
chef, good, yes,
Chef.
you got it. Chef. Pero lo escribo, lo escribe lo mismo. Okay. Chef. Chef. Cool. Y dos más, dos más. Okay. Es mucho vocabulario, ¿no? Han aprendido mucho en las últimas 2 semanas. Bueno, Pedro, what does he do?
He is a painter.
Bueno, creo que no. Creo
No.
que está construyendo algo.
He's a builder.
Bueno, se puede decir builder, pero más común es construction worker.
Ah.
Eso es nuevo. Construction worker.
Construction worker.
Yeah, so he's a construction worker.
Okay.
Okay. Y finalmente, el último, Jesús, what does he do?
He's a gardenman.
Bueno, pero está trabajando, si están trabajando en una granja.
farming.
Farmer, yeah. He's a farmer. He's a farmer. Okay. Good, good. Necesitan practicar un poco más con trabajos porque hay muchos trabajos, ¿no? Hay muchos. Y no podemos revisitar todos ahora.
Ok.
Bueno, ahora vamos a hablar un poco de la familia. Familia. Entonces, ¿pueden ver esta familia?
Sí. ¿No?
¿Más o menos? Ok. ¿Pueden ver las líneas? ¿Dónde están las padres y todo? ¿Más o menos?
Sí. More or less.
Okay, more or less. More or less, good. So, talking about this person right here, Kelly. Kelly, okay. Pedro.
Yes.
Who is Kelly's grandma?
Who is Kelly what?
Who is Kelly's grandma? Or grandma or grandmother?
Kelly's grandmother is Florence.
Good, Florence. Yeah, good. Kelly's
grandma
is Florence. Okay. Perfect. Okay. Jesus, yes. Using the verb to have. Usando el verbo to have. Okay. How many uncles does Kelly have?
I think she has wait a moment, please. Two uncles.
Okay. Who are his uncles?
I think is Thomas?
Yeah.
Francis.
No. It's Thomas and Thomas.
Who is Francis?
Creo que Frances en este caso es una mujer.
Sí.
Bueno, en inglés podemos usar Frances
por uncles. Sorry.
Uncles, sí.
Yes.
No estamos hablando de mujeres. Pero voy a enseñar una cosa. Frances por un hombre necesitamos poner un I. We need to put an I, okay? Así, Francis, okay? Pero por una mujer es con un E, an E, Francis, así, okay?
This is the word or this is the pronunciation?
The pronunciation is the same, es igual. Francis.
Okay, the word is different.
The word is different, yeah.
Okay,
Pedro.
Daniel, I have a question.
Yes.
Why does Thomas... why have Thomas two wife? Thomas has.
Yeah, Pedro, I don't know. It's a strange family.
It's
a strange family. I just saw that. I just saw that right now.
Okay.
Good question.
It's a mother family.
Yeah, it's a different family. I don't know. Maybe from a different place. Yeah.
Okay.
A very liberal family, we'll say. A liberal.
Yes.
Right? Okay. Pedro, how many yes. cousins does Kelly have?
It's Kelly. They have no, she has two cousins.
She has two cousins. Who are her cousins?
Christopher Gordon and Gran Ashley Hals.
Perfect. Excellent. Okay. Jesus.
Yes.
Speaking of Billy Janelle Halls. Billy Janelle Halls up here. Okay.
About his family.
Okay. Now, speaking of her, I want you to tell me, how many nephews does Billy Janelle Halls have?
I think she has two nephews.
Okay, who?
Is Kelly and I don't see the name. Ari, Lauren.
Ah, okay, okay. Pero tiene que recordar, okay, que en inglés sobrinos no es igual. Okay.
Yes.
Es solamente por quién.
Por sobrinas.
No. Cuando decimos nephews, ¿qué significa? Yes. How many nephews does she have?
Nephews y sobrinos.
Sobrinos, pero solamente los hombres.
Masculinos. Ah.
Sí, solamente masculinos.
Then she has a nephews.
How many?
Anybody. Nadie, ninguno.
Creo que sí. Pero.
Why?
Creo que Kelly es un hombre. Creo.
Ah, Kelly is a man.
Sí, creo que sí. Pero también puedes ver que Billy Janelle Halls no es la mamá de Christopher y Grant. Es la tía.
Ah.
She is the aunt.
Yes, yes, yes.
So.
Then, Kelly and Grant Ashley. Ashley is a woman.
Sí, pero se puede usar Ashley como hombre y mujer en inglés. Okay?
Okay.
Pero es the middle name. Middle
okay.
name.
And then she has two nephews. They are Kelly and Grant.
And Christopher. She has three.
Christopher.
Sí. Él aquí. Okay.
Ah, okay. Sobrinos. Oh, sorry.
Sí, sí. Sobrinos.
Kelly Christopher Agran. Yes.
Okay. Y Jesús, ¿cómo se dice sobrina?
Narcy.
Niece. Se dice niece.
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 Niece. Okay. Niece. Okay. Good. Very good. Okay. So, speaking of, Pedro,
yes.
I understand now. I understand now. Tienen que mirar a los años de las chicas, de las mujeres, las esposas y todas. Okay. Francis Mary Smith is dead.
Okay.
Entonces, Debra Dene Embrek es su segunda esposa. It's his second wife.
Okay.
Okay. So, if that's the case, okay, then Pedro.
Yes.
What is Debra's relationship to Christopher. What is Deborah's relationship?
Deborah is aunt?
No. Deborah is his, ¿recuerdas la palabra stepmother?
Ah, okay.
¿Recuerdas?
Ah, verdad.
¿Recuerdas?
Sí. She's the stepmother.
Yeah. Deborah is Christopher's stepmother.
Deborah is his stepmother.
Good. Okay. So, Jesus.
Yes.
Speaking of Vicky. Okay. Over here, Vicky.
Yes.
What is Deborah's relationship to Vicky?
She's love sister.
She's her what?
Love sister.
No, bueno.
Es su cuñada.
Sí, quieres decir, she's her sister-in-law.
Yes.
Sí, casi.
She's her sister-in-law.
Good, she's her sister-in-law. Okay.
Sorry.
And Pedro.
Yes.
What is Thomas, or who is Thomas in relation to Billy Janelle? Who is Thomas in relation to Billy Janelle?
He is her cousin.
En español.
¿Cuánto se llama? ¿Su cuñado?
¿Su cuñado? Okay.
I don't remember.
Okay.
Cuñado.
¿Cómo se dice cuñada? Jesús.
No, bueno.
Sister-in-law.
Okay. Ah, verdad. Brother-in-law.
Good. He's her.
She's brother. He's her brother-in-law.
Perfect. He's her brother-in-law. Okay, good. Es un poco difícil, ¿no? Recordar todas las palabras en la familia. Sí. La verdad es que han aprendido muchas cosas en las últimas dos semanas, pero ahora tienen el vocabulario para empezar, para practicar. Okay? Y quizás necesitan un poco de tiempo practicar lo que ya han aprendido. Okay? Porque era un curso grande en un poco tiempo. Okay?
Yes.
Pero ahora es un base.
Uh-huh.
Okay. Bueno, entonces vamos a hablar de descripciones físicas. Okay? Physical descriptions. Who missed the class? About physical descriptions. ¿Quién ha faltado a la clase de descripciones físicas?
Ah, yo.
Okay, bueno. Entonces, Pedro, ¿entiendes un poco de descripciones físicas?
No lo sé.
No mucho, okay. Bueno, vamos a ver. We're going to see. Okay. So, Pedro, or sorry, Jesus, to start. Can you describe the first person? Okay. En estas fotos queremos hacer más o menos tres cosas. Vamos a describir el pelo, los ojos si podemos, y el pelo facial. el pelo de la cara. Entonces, número uno, aquí. Jesús, can you describe him?
He has a black hair.
Good, he has black hair. He has black hair. ¿Qué más podemos decir de su pelo? De su cabello.
Blonde? No.
No.
Liso, I don't remember liso.
Well, straight.
Straight.
Straight. ¿Y está larga o está largo?
Short, short.
Entonces, he has straight,
short,
short,
and black hair.
Hair. Okay. Recuerden que con ojos y con cosas que estamos describiendo, podemos poner todos los adjetivos juntos. No necesitamos poner M. Okay. En la lista. Bueno, ¿qué más? ¿Qué más? What else?
I don't see your eyes.
No, you can't see his eyes. Okay. Pero, ¿qué puedes decir de sus ojos?
I don't know.
¿Qué tiene enfrente de sus ojos?
She has glasses.
Good. He has glasses. Okay.
Has glasses.
No necesitamos decir a glasses porque glasses es siempre es plural. It's always plural, right?
Uh-huh.
So he has glasses, okay? ¿Y qué más?
He has a mustache.
Good. He has a mustache. ¿Qué significa mustache?
Bigote.
Bigote. Okay. He has a mustache. Perfect. Okay. Pedro, do you want to try number two?
Okay. He has a curly medium blonde hair.
Good. We say he has curly medium length blonde hair. Okay. Cuando queremos decir medium, necesitamos decir length. Okay.
Ah, okay.
He has curly medium length blonde hair. Good. Anything else?
He has a blue glasses.
Sure, he has blue glasses. ¿Y cómo se dice gafas del sol?
Gafas de sol. Sunglasses.
Sunglasses. Y es solamente una palabra. Está juntos.
Sunglasses.
Okay. Sunglasses. So, he has blue sunglasses.
Okay, he has blue sunglasses.
¿Y puedes describir su nariz?
He has a long nose or
nose.
Nose.
Yeah, nose. We can say he has a long nose. Sure.
He has a long nose.
He has a long nose. Good. Perfect. Okay. All right, what else do we have here? Okay. This guy right here, Jesus.
Yes.
Can you describe him?
He's a bald.
Good, and we don't say he's a bald, we just say he's bald. Calvo.
He's
right?
Bald.
He's bald. Mm-hmm. Okay, and?
He has a beard.
Good. He has a beard, una barba. Perfect.
Beard is with mustache, ¿no?
Yeah, but remember Jesús, cuando él tiene una barba con un bigote, solamente necesitamos decir
beard.
Okay? No necesitamos incluir el bigote. Uh-huh. We don't need to include the mustache.
Okay.
Okay. Bueno, no tenemos mucho más tiempo, entonces vamos a ir a estos ejemplos, okay? Hablando de simple past tense, okay? Do you remember simple past tense?
Later.
El pasado simple?
Yes, simple past tense.
Simple past tense, all right. So, put the verbs in the simple past tense. Put the verbs in the simple past tense. So, Pedro, number one.
Okay. Last year, I went to England on Good. Holiday.
Good. Last year, I went to England on holiday. Went. Perfect. So the past of go, right? Irregular. Irregular. Jesus, number two.
It was fantastic.
It was fantastic.
Was fantastic.
Perfect. Pedro, number three.
I visited lots of interesting places. I was with two friends of mine.
Perfect. Okay. Visited. Good. Pedro, how do you spell that?
Visited. Yes?
Yeah.
V I S I T E D.
Perfect. Visited.
Visited.
Good. Visited. Jesus, number four.
In the morning, we walked in the streets of London.
Great. And you said that correctly, too. You didn't say walked. You said walked. Good. Very good. Okay. Jesus, how do you spell walked?
Yes. W A L Q no Q
no
K A no E D
Good, excellent. W A L K E D. Perfect. Pedro, number
yes.
five.
In the evening, siempre tengo que poner el pasado o
sí, en el pasado.
Okay, in the evenings we went to pubs.
Good, again went. Good. Jesus, number six.
The weather was strangely fine.
Good. The weather was strangely fine. Okay. And Pedro, number seven. Pero mira, es negativo.
Ah, es negativo.
Sí.
Okay. It wasn't rain a lot. It was not rain a lot.
Bueno, cuando hablamos en el pasado, necesitamos usar, o en el negativo, necesitamos usar el verbo do. Okay? Pero en el pasado.
Ah, right. It didn't rain a lot.
Good. It didn't rain a lot. Good. Okay. And Jesus, number eight.
But we saw some beautiful rainbows.
Rainbows. Good. Perfect.
Rainbows.
And number nine, Pedro.
Okay. Where do you No, where did you spend your last holiday?
Perfect. Where did you spend your last holiday?
Spend.
Good, where because remember, spend? If it's a question, right? If it's a question or if it's negative, okay? A question or negative, we need to use the verb to do, right? And if it's in the past, that is did, okay? Okay, one last thing, guys. One last thing, okay? Perdón, tengo demasiado sol. Oh, qué mala suerte. Un momento. Okay, ahora sí. Bueno, hoy vamos a hablar de preposiciones de lugar, muy rápido, okay? ¿Tienen 5 minutos?
Yes.
Okay, perfect. So, here we go, okay? I have 3 things. Okay, what do I have here? What 3 things?
Pencil, pen.
Pen.
Cell phone.
Cell phone or phone, yeah, and?
Glass.
Glass, okay, okay. Prepositions of place, okay. Jesus, where is the phone?
The phone is in the glass.
Good. The phone is in the glass.
Perfect. Or inside, too.
Or inside. You could say inside as well.
Okay. Because it's all in.
Exactly.
All is in.
Sure. Yeah. Pedro, where is the pen?
The pen is on the cell phone.
Good. The pen is on the cell phone. Jesus, where is the cell phone?
The cell phone is under the pen.
Good. The cell phone is under the pen. Okay. Pedro, where is the glass?
The glass is next to the cell phone or good. Behind.
No, the cell not phone. Behind. Not behind.
Not behind?
No. Next to or?
Beside.
Beside, good.
Yes.
Yeah, that I know, behind me. And beside.
See, behind, etc.
Good, okay.
And near?
And near.
Yeah, pero, it's possible.
Sí, pero cuando decimos near, Jesús es más como cerca de. Okay? Mm-hmm. Entonces se puede decir es near. Near, it's near, it's near, it's near, it's near. Y ahora está lejos, it is far. Oh.
Okay.
Mm. Okay. Jesus, where is the glass?
The glass is between the pens.
Good. The glass is between the pens. Excellent. Okay. Pedro, where is the pen?
Where is the pen?
Yeah.
The pen is in front of the glass?
Perfect. The pen is in front of the glass. Exactly. And Jesus, where is the glass?
I think the glass is behind of pen.
Good. Behind the pen. Not behind of, but behind the pen.
Behind of.
Behind the pen. Good. Okay. Now, speaking of rooms in the house. Cuartos en la casa. Okay. Jesus, where is the shower?
The shower is... ¿Dónde está el baño, el lavabo?
Bueno, ¿cómo se dice shower?
In Spanish.
Sí, no, sí, en Spanish.
Baño.
No, eso es bathtub, bathtub. Pero shower es
Lavadero.
más o menos igual.
Lavadero.
La
I
ducha.
don't know.
La ducha.
Okay.
So, where is the shower?
Shower
Good. The shower is in the bathroom. Perfect. Pedro, where is the oven?
oven. What is oven? Oven era para todo, ¿cierto? Podía estar en la cocina y en el baño, ¿o no?
No.
¿Cuál era el
Eso
oven?
es sink. Estás hablando.
Ah, verdad. Sink.
¿Qué significa oven? Hoy en Inglaterra usan otra palabra.
No me acuerdo.
Horno, el horno.
Ah, horno, ok. The oven, yes, the oven is in the kitchen.
Good. The oven is in the kitchen.
The
Good.
oven is in the kitchen.
Jesus, where is the couch?
Don't
Okay. Es como sofá.
couch. Okay, the couch is in the living room.
Good, is in the living room. Y la verdad es que Jesús, normalmente en Estados Unidos y en Canadá usamos couch más que sofá. Okay.
Couch.
Couch. Okay,
Couch.
¿qué más? ¿Qué más? Okay. Pedro.
Yes.
Where is the dining room table?
The dining room table is in the dining room.
Okay, good, good. Easy one. The dining room table is in the dining room.
Yeah. Yes.
And last thing, Jesus, another easy one. Where is the bed?
The bed is in the living room.
No.
The
Where is the
bed
bed?
is in the room.
What room?
My room.
The bedroom. Yeah, the bed is in the bedroom. Yeah, there you go. Okay. Awesome, guys. Hey, listen, this is the last class. So, listen. Study what we have learned, okay? Tienen que estudiar lo que ya hemos aprendido. Y creo que vamos a tener más clases, pero esta semana no. ¿Okay? Entonces, continúen a seguir Colingo y vamos a tener más clases en el futuro. Pero tienen mucho vocabulario para practicar antes que la próxima clase. ¿Verdad? Y
Yes.
los dos, recuerden el sistema que tengo con las tarjetas.
Yes.
Deben usarlo porque tenemos mucho vocabulario para practicar.
Okay.
Okay. Cool, guys. Awesome.
Okay.
Thank you very much. You guys have been great. Fantastic.
Okay. Daniel,
Okay. Yes.
o sea, ¿van a seguir con la unidad 2, la unidad 3 y así?
¿Cómo?
¿Van a seguir realizando los cursos?
Sí, pero no sé
No,
exactamente
no sabes cuándo.
cuándo. Necesitamos hablar un poco esta semana para hacer planes concretos.
Ah, okay.
¿Okay? Pero cuando sabemos, los dos van a estar las primeras personas que enviamos
Ah,
de mail
okay.
mensajes. ¿Okay? El
Okay,
informe.
great.
¿Okay?
Fantastic, Daniel.
Perfect, guys. Thanks a
Thank you.
lot.
Okay.
All
So,
right.
see you soon.
See you soon. See you soon.
See you
Bye, guys.
soon. Bye.